Well, here we are, back for a bit more of No Man's Sky. I've barely stopped playing this since I streamed it a couple of days ago, which does mean that I kind of fucked up my I did fuck up my save. I started a save with a couple of pals, multiplayer, I kept forgetting which save was which. And I ended up doing half the sort of early missions on the wrong save, the one that I was going to use just for streaming. So if the planet looks different, it's because I started again, got back up to where we were before. And now we're all ready to take off. Last time I played, I had fixed up my ship, refueled it, all that good stuff, got my, whatever the visor thing is called, fixed, so that I could check out these little lads. Yeah, look at these. Little babby one. Jurassic Park up there. I got all that stuff fixed up my ship. I've had a little explore since. I've just been sort of cruising around this planet, scanning stuff. I probably need a bit more fuel. Some of these blue shinies. I've got enough of this blue shiny that I had to win. I need to make a metal plating, so I'll get some of these rocks, big Brussels sprouts. This planet is so weird because there are plants that look like rocks, and rocks that look like plants, and plants that look like dicks, and rocks that look like pancakes. But it does have a dog, no, a bird. It has a bird that looks like one of my dogs. Where is it? Look at this little munchkin. I'm gonna have to get a picture, but this looks... this freaky little bird looks like one of my dogs. Both of my dogs, really, because both of my dogs look the same. We have perfected cloning in Leeds. We've not shared it with the rest of the world yet, but we have perfected cloning. I've cloned my dogs, and now that I've figured that out, I'm gonna take off. So, all systems functional. Seek answers among the stars. Piece of piss. I thought it was going to be empty then. Right, we're off. Oh, they're birds. No, stars, not birds. Fucking hell. I haven't had a coffee yet, so I clearly can't tell the difference between stars and birds. Okay, so we're in space. Orbital flight achieved. No achievement, though, no trophy. Fucking game. Test starship systems. Test flight controls and thrust. R2. Well, I'm doing that, but it's not. Oh, there we go. Ticked off now. Test starship systems. Test boost. I've already done that. Let's do it again. We're off. Hold L1 and R1 to test pulse engine. What I've been doing, like an idiot, is holding those buttons down, but I found out that you only need to wait for that countdown to finish. You just need to wait for the countdown to finish, and it'll just keep going until you run out of fuel or slam into a planet. Incoming message. What do I... Oh. Answer by pressing that one. Starship communicator. I haven't even looked at all this stuff yet. Apart from switching to first-person view, because it's a bit easier getting through doors. Anyway, incoming transmission. Please identify yourself. Yeah, I'll identify myself. You're not kidding. You're not alone. Follow the buzzards.
We're coming.
Broadcast ends as strangely as it began. The final piece of the signal appears to be a set of planetary coordinates. Is that what this is on the dash 1616 input coordinate data? All coordinates to find the signal source. Pilot towards a coordinate marker and engage the bus engine. If he's taking me back where I just came from, that toxic planet. It is! Unless it's around the other side. Do I go around the planet? Can I go around the planet? Pop out. There we go. Look! Okay, I hit a tree. Even though flight in this game is like super easy, it's and it's kind of hard to crash into the ground. I still managed to hit trees and bounce off rocks and stuff. I like how easy they've made flight in this compared to, say, Elite Dangerous. And the only thing the two games have in common is space and spaceships. Whoa, big tree. Fuck. But flight in that, well, I mean, it's a simulator, so it's harder. But it's super easy in this game, and it's really fluid and fun. I want to scan one of these little fellas. What is it? Little flower face fella. Oh, fucking sentinels. I haven't really come across sentinels yet. I mean, I've seen them. And I know they're little fuckers. But I haven't had an altercation with one just yet. Anyway, fucking checkpoint. The sparking wires of the machine generate a signal, tapping out its broadcast into the void. Whoever left this message is long gone. It's actually a recording of Return of the Mac. No fuel reached. Failed to reach station. Hazard protection low. No choice but to cheese it underground. Deployed base computer. Signal contains plans for a base computer and a terrain manipulator. With any luck, the base computer will hold more information. Give you the plans. Give it to me. When placed, contacts Universal Cartographic Archive to establish ownership of land. I don't want to own any land on this planet. Successful registration allows construction of base modules across any site of the user's choosing. Okay, so I guess if I have a base computer, I can build buildings, bases, which I haven't really done yet. When that was introduced, that was when it stopped working on my PC. I think it was just too much for it to handle, which is weird because it runs games like Elite Dangerous. Terrain manipulator, advanced terraforming device. Module overloads existing multi-tool systems, allowing the user to reshape regions as they wish. I am unto a god, or I will be when I get a terrain manipulator. Charged with metallic elements like Megadeth. Whoa! Need to scan. I mean, these rocks all look the same. So, I don't know what I've scanned and what I haven't, but I've definitely scanned big flat rocks before. I've definitely scanned these Brussels sprout looking rocks. If I need copper to make the terrain manipulator, but I need a terrain manipulator to mine copper. Oh, base computer requires copper. Copper requires terrain manipulator. Terrain manipulator is a multi-tool upgrade. Allows mining of ores. Reshapes the world in my image. Digging tunnels, creating new landmasses. Tunnels would be handy on a shitty planet like this. Get your breath back. Okay. Yeah. Where is it? That one. Carbon nanotubes, dihydrogen jelly. Okay. There's actually not much dihydrogen on this planet. It's kind of like little clusters here and there. So, take it while I can get it. What else do I need? Carbon nanotubes, I think. Oh, two of them. Well, I'll put the jelly in. Jelly.
A little bit of the
jelly. Now I need some rocks. No, I don't. I need plants and carbon nanotubes. But not a farty plant. Will do. I'm really wary of that sentinel now, even though it's probably really far away. First things first, do that. Oh no! Oh no, I needed that. Oh fuck. At least I got enough. Right. That was really stupid. Put in my tubes. Okay, I have a Terrain player. Activate terrain manipulator with Triangle. Use analysis to advise me to locate deposits. Copper deposit, that was quite relatively close. 600? 600 U's, whatever U is. This thing looks like, what's it called? The first Reaver that you meet in Mass Effect. Joe? No, I can't think what it was called. The Reaver in Mass Effect 1. Shiny Joe. God, I don't know what's wrong with me this morning. I'm not switched on at all. Sentinel. Is that Sentinel not going to like me doing a mine on this thing? I just want that little bit. He's leaving. I think we're good. He's coming back. He didn't seem bothered. He's nice. Brilliant. As soon as I turn my back, he's going to be fucking up. That's wicked. Right, back to the ship. Oh shit. I might need to get more sodium at some point. 29 left. And there's none on the way. No, there is. Still there. Oh, there's loads! Stock up! Oh, what's going on? Oh, that's an unidentified plant. Shoot. Oh, and I never checked out this little outpost. I just ran right past it. Health, we've got plenty. I don't want this rusted metal. Just discard it. Oh, new item. I haven't looked at the catalog yet, I don't think. Curiosities? This looks like the Minecraft logo, kind of, if it was round and gross. Oh, that's what I found. Korvax Convergence Cube, used by the Korvax for storage of historical and cultural information. Worth 13 large. Korvax casing of a disconnected electronic life form that was too distant from its kind to be refreshed with a new entity. So is that the hardware, the body of a Korvax that I'm lugging around? Highly prized by all species. It's kind of a corpse, but it's kind of like an empty PC box. Okay, well, I'll save. Back off then, that's the area that I discovered a little while ago. Oh, fuck, I keep forgetting to do stuff. Okay, portable refiner, bang it down. Get some fuel. I need 30 chromatic metal made from copper. I find it really hard to read the titles of these when you've just got a grid full of... Oh, so 60 copper gets me 30 chromatic metal. There we go. Look at it. Look at it. Done. Okay, base computer claims a site for construction. Find a suitable area and deploy the base computer. I don't want to deploy it here because this planet... it's not exactly a paradise. What is this? Ooh. Okay. Shit, I need to make some more juice for the ship. Oh no, I need more dihydrogen. Fuck, I thought I needed dihydrogen jelly. Shit! Right. So I need some blue shinies. What's that? What was that? Subterranean relic. And blue shinies. Get the piece out. Pop out. Okay, what do I need, like 40? Oh shit. Hide. Oh! That wasn't very good hiding. Okay, this seems to have left me alone. Quite close. I forget you can tag stuff. Alright, I think the sentinel is fucked off now. Oh, these are not subterranean at all, they're just terranean, they're just sitting there on the surface. Thought I'd have to dig with the terrain manipulator. Well, goodbye, weird plant that looks like Sovereign. That's the name of the Reaver. And there he is, mighty Sovereign. Reaver or Reaper? Big ship, anyway. The big bad ship in Mass Effect. Bad lad. Fuel. And... fuel in there. Right, we're off. Straight into a tree. Not my fault. Okay. I don't know what's in this system. Is there a way to find out? Oh, so there are more. There are two more planets. In Use Vier Yacht, discovered by me. I guess that's what these on the radar are, down the bottom. Let's get off this shit here. Hopefully we can scan the planets like from from orbit. Seems very good. Maybe some sort of fire blasted hellscape. Whoa. Okay, so this must be the chateau we just came from. Yeah, Zankol Tau, discovered by me. That looks pretty gross. Brown. That looks okay. What's the other dot? The right one. Something there, a little dot. In space. Yeah, it's definitely getting bigger. So to speak. Is that a ship? That's a station. Far away it is. It could be huge and take me hours to get there. No, I think we're good. Shattered planet. Shattered. How do I get in? I just want to get in. Once I've been in here and seen what's up, then I will head down to one of those planets, build a base computer, and start shaping the planet in my image. Forget how cool the space stations look in this, and how badass the music can be. The soundtrack is actually really good. It's great for work. I think I said that last time. Sometimes when I'm working, I'll stick this on in the studio, and it's good, non-distracting music. Oh shit, I don't want to go down there. There's no one here. I thought there would be people. There's people back there. I guess these are shops. What's up, dude? Technology merchant. Oh, all the stuff I want to sell is on my ship. Appearance modifier. Oh, how long have we got? Recalibrate personal visuals. I do like any game where you can pick how you look. I've spent fucking ages doing that. Little Robo Man. Oh, there he is. He's got a head. I like these big boys. It's a Power Ranger. Oh, I've seen Lightbulb Head Cat. What are these things? Cat boys and robots. This is going to take a while. Maybe I should do this when I'm not recording. That looks like a street cleaner. Like the little road sweepers. I think I want this ship. I saw the pilot a second ago. Here he is. Oh, gestures. Yes. Hi, guy. Oh, please hold. How do I change my view? There we go. There's me. What's up, scholar entity? Oh, trade negotiations. He knows what's up. He knows what's coming. Open to discuss trade goods and the purchase of their starship. Okay, how much you want? I don't see a price anywhere. Compare. Oh, okay. So if I trade in my fighter with 15 slots, Oh man, mine's worth less than 400,000. His big old hauler is worth 12.6 million. Fuck. Okay. Good day to you, sir. 3rd person view is really weird when you've been in 1st person for a while. There's a camera in this game, isn't there? Photo mode. I don't know why I find this little face so funny. It looks like he's wearing a chef hat. Thumbs up, guys. Oh, fuck. Oh, this guy gave me a thumbs up back. What's up, brother? Oh. Kovacs looks at me briefly before beginning to drum their fingers on the surface in front of them. They beat a rhythm. Oh, very nice. Oh, shit. Oh, man. Request dialect help, because I don't know what you're saying. Presents a series of symbols that seem to represent words I might learn. Oh, travel. I'm pretty well traveled man. I want to know the word for that dance. It's quite busy. It's nice to see these space stations with people in them, because what they used to be just that sort of entrance lobby where you'd park your ship. And oh, it's a teleporter. Shit. I don't want to do that. I want to sell stuff. Yeah, there used to just be a little side room, a little sort of canteen with maybe one guy in it. Cartographer. What? I just want to sell my stuff. Who do I sell it to? What's this guy doing? Mission agent. Missions. Oh, I'm just going to use this trade terminal. Because I don't know who I want to sell this stuff to. Maybe those guys are for buying stuff. Adventure space on my ship. Hey. Watch out, pal. Is that his brain sticking out the top, or is that like a horn? The warrior looks as if they might want something dead. Thankfully, it doesn't seem to be me. Gives a little bit of help, mate. Warrior draws themselves up, proud to be teaching their language. They present a selection of symbols, each representing a type of Viking word. I guess this is how you learn languages from people in this. They'd show you a bunch of symbols. Friend. Friendship symbol. Learn the Viking word for help. I love all the different races and stuff. Right. That will do. Oh shit. Lobbed out here. Okay. Sharded planet, or where was the other one? Bleak planet. Sharded planet sounds less gross. Bleak sounds awful. Like it's either gonna be red hot or toxic as shit. So let's dive into this bad boy. New planet, new me. New year, new planet. Something like that. Let's get through these clouds and see what we're doing. Got a big rock. Big rocks. A lot of flat stuff. Oh! Trees? What are these? Is this like a... Are they naturally occurring? I don't like that yellow sky. That's kind of... That's kind of gross. Okay. Let's get out and take it in. Weather, indetectable burning. Sentinels, limited, that's good. Flora, high. Fauna, regular. What are these turds? Pepper upright. Okay, let's take a look at our potential new home. What is this thing? Mineral. That is wild. It's floating. Formation process. Jet pressure. Notes. Porous. Nothing about the fact it's floating and almost perfectly rectangular. .38.5. Pleasantly warm. Well, I'd call that too hot, but, you know, I'm British. I'll tell you what, I'm going to leave it there for now. This seems like as much of a cliffhanger as we could want. I'm going to leave it there, pick this up later, hopefully. And we need to decide if we're sticking with this planet or trying the other one, which I can't see from here. Oh, but now the sky is turning blue. Look at that sunrise. Maybe that was just horrible yellow night. You know what? Maybe I could stay here. We'll see. If you've liked this video, give it a like. Subscribe to the channel, leave a comment, let me know what you'd like to see, what you think we should do next. I've got plenty more of these videos coming up. Like the channel, subscribe, share it with your friends. Thanks so much, guys. Catch you later.